Hi there, this is Fred with Wentworth CCTV, and today we will be going over video 4 in our security camera installation series. And this will be networking the camera that we activated using SADP in video 3. We're going to network that to Hikvision's platform. So we'll just Google Hikvision. I know I say Hikvision half the time. The correct way to say this is Hikvision. And we will go to their support and resources, downloads, and we're going to pick client software this time. And we are going to scroll down to IVMS for Windows. There's an IVMS for Mac as well, but this is a Windows computer. So we will do the Windows download. It brings you to this download page, and we want to click under software, the IVMS download. And it looks like our file here has downloaded, so we will open that. Okay, we have clicked the executable file. And you see we are here with the installation wizard. You just agree to the terms and agreements. You can click on here if you wish to read those. Alrighty, it looks as though the installation has completed, so we will go ahead and click finish. Okay, so the IVMS program has completed its installation. And it will bring you to a login screen, and a lot of people get confused on this. This username and password has nothing to do with your camera that we've networked, or a DVR if you may have a DVR. This is simply a username and password that will be installed on the computer or laptop that you're using, tablet, whatever it may be, to access this program. So you can put anything that you like in here. I always tell my clients to put the same username and password here as you do for the cameras. Always use the same username and passwords for your camera equipment, and then you don't forget what they are. And I also tell them to click the auto login box. And essentially what that means is you'll never see this login again. When you click on the icon for the program on your desktop, it will automatically open without prompting for a username or password. So we'll go ahead and hit login now. Once you hit login, you're going to be prompted to enter password protection questions, which will help you in the event that you forget the username and password we just created. So you can pick, you know, your father's name, your favorite teacher's name, whatever you like, your favorite game. Put your answers in here and click login. Okay, now that we have finished installing and logging in, we are in the main menu view. I call it the control panel here. And the very first thing we want to do is go to device management, because right now we have no devices managed by IVMS. So we click device management. Okay, now we are in the device management portion of IVMS. And as you can see, there are no devices added. So what we need to do is scan for online devices. And you will see below, this refreshes every 60 seconds looking for Hikvision devices on your network. So it knows this is our camera. So we want to click add. Okay, what we have here is the device add button. And we are going to name our device, whatever we want to name it, basement camera. The port will populate, as well as the IP address will populate automatically. and we just need to enter the username and password that we assigned to the camera or NVR using SADP in video 3. So this is the username, which is admin, and the password you created in SADP. And at this point, you can see that our camera is now online in IVMS. It shows us that here. It shows us we have a strong password. It shows us here the full serial number. So this camera has been networked properly to IVMS, which means we can switch over to main view. We will see basement. And we can click there, and there is our picture of the basement in the dark. This is what a camera looks like with nice night vision. You can also customize in IVMS the name of the camera. There's these three dots right here, and you can hit modify camera name and label as you like. And from here, you can go back to the control panel, and we could add another device if we had one online. This is continually scanning your network for Hikvision devices, and every time one becomes available, whether it's another camera or a DVR, PTZ, whatever the case is, you'll be able to add it. Go back to control panel, back to main view, and this concludes video 4. Which is networking a camera or DVR locally using IVMS. So we can use this program now to pull up this camera locally. By locally, we mean on the same network. So doing it this particular way, we need to be able to pull up the camera while we're at the same location as the modem. So If this is a workplace camera, we can pull it up at work. If it's a home camera, we can pull it up at home. That's local. In video 5, we will be looking at doing the same exact thing with remote capabilities. And what that means is if we're home and want to view work on a different network outside of the local network, we're going to log in remotely using this same IVMS software. And you can look for that information in video 5. Remember to like our videos, subscribe so you are notified when we update the latest video and post it. And also, our subscribers will have email access to us and can ask questions or for support, and we will make a video for you to help you.